Hi friends, welcome to EduTap. So just let me know friends if you are able to hear me clearly please. Just please mention that in the comment section below so that we can start with the session. I hope you guys are able to hear me. Please let me know in the comment section below. Okay, so hi friends, happy new year first of all guys, meeting you for the first time in the new year. So I just hope this year turns out to be great for all of us and we clear our examinations. So yes, hi Jagannath, good evening. Vibhav says yeah, it's audible, thank you so much. So okay, so we'll just wait for 2 minutes friends and then after that we'll begin with the session. So as we have been doing the series wherein each week we'll come out with the discussion regarding the important schemes, and these schemes are relevant for our ESI paper, right? And this ESI paper is common for RBI grade B examination, it is common for NABARD grade A examination, SEBI grade A, right? So we have a lot of examinations that we can cover. So Sumit Chaudhary, happy new year Sumit, thank you so much for the wishes and I really hope that it turns out to be great year for you guys. Yeah Gopal, thank you so much, happy new year. So guys, we'll just wait for 1 or 2 minutes, let our friends join in and then we'll begin with the session. So I just hope you all are going good with your preparation. We have a lot of time available with us for the 2019 examination and we need to make the most out of the time available. So I would really recommend you guys to be on your toes and keep preparing well, right? Because now is the time wherein you can work on your weaknesses and you can polish your strengths, right? Once the examination starts to come near, then it we go to a panic mode, right? So we don't need those things. So Farzan says, yeah, good evening Farzan. Shakti, happy new year, same to you. So friends, I really hope that you know you all are doing your preparation, and if there is any doubt regarding strategies, kindly give us a call. I'm there, we'll just figure it out how we need to plan the entire syllabus, right? So okay, so Srinivas, I think you have a specific query. What you can do is just give us a call on 8146207241. So we will definitely schedule a call with you. We can discuss regarding your doubt that you have placed here, that you want to start your RBI grade B preparation along with SBI PO. So we'll address that also, don't worry. Okay, so definitely give us a call. We will schedule a call with you. In fact, I'll take it personally, don't worry. So yes, guys. So we'll just wait just a minute more and then we'll begin, right? Just a minute more. Yeah, Prasanna, happy new year to you too. Thank you so much. And I hope you have been revising the schemes that we are discussing, okay? So last week also we had discussed one important scheme. So I want you guys to keep revising them, okay? Because what happens is once you just leave it, it is not easy for you to remember all those things. In fact, one of you was even asking me, how do I remember all these important facts, right? You have to. So Mayur, yes, happy new year. Thank you. Wish you the same. Okay, guys, I think we are good to go for the session, right? We'll begin with the session and let our friends join in later as well. So yes, okay, so today's scheme, again, the same thing what we're going to do is we will take up a paragraph, okay? It is going to be on the lines of 2 marker questions, okay? And friends, let me tell you that off late, we are seeing a trend wherein in the examination, you're getting paragraph-based questions and these paragraphs define certain important characteristics of the schemes, okay? They do not let the name out in the particular paragraph and most of the times, they ask you to first identify which scheme it is, yes, and the next kind of questions that we are getting is fill in the blanks type of questions, okay? So we will address both, okay? So first of all, let me just tell you the list of chapters for the scheme. Like you can see, these are the list which is present in the ESI chapter, out of which we expect that there are good number of schemes that the government has released, and obviously there are going to be questions when it comes to ESI. So friends, we always get confused whether, you know, static part needs to be given importance to or your current affairs part. So I would like to say that yes, current affair dominates in ESI, but do not neglect your static part. For current affairs, one of the important component is scheme, and we are addressing that here, right? So before that, let me just quickly tell you about our results. So in 2017, there were 27 final selections in RBI Grade B, 2017 from EduTap, 11 in NABARD. 2018, there are 26 in NABARD Grade A. 2018, we have got more than 287 interview calls for RBI Grade B 2018, and more than 200 students have cleared the SEBI Phase 1 2018, right? So yeah, we also offer individual courses, RBI Phase 1 plus Phase 2 full video course. There is non-video course as well, and you can also see that NABARD also we have Phase 1 plus Phase 2 full video course. We also offer combo courses, SEBI, RBI and NABARD together, RBI and NABARD together, SEBI and RBI together, right? Okay friends, so here we are with the session today. So okay, hi Hari Gopal, joined in new, happy new year, and Swapnil, you too. Okay, so let me just tell you the paragraph first. Okay, so we'll go with the paragraph. So what I've done is, in the previous lecture, what we were doing is we were having a look at a paragraph. Now I have taken the same paragraph, but I've modified the scheme a bit. Okay, now why we are doing this, it is going to be like an exercise wherein gradually we'll cover all the schemes. Okay, so here you can, let us first have a look at the, you know, the paragraph. Even as the government says that there's a lack of data on jobs, an analysis of available numbers shows that three flagship employment generation programs have generated 27 lakh employment opportunities in the last 4.5 years, right? So again friends, you can see here that this particular paragraph deals with somewhat employment generation program. Okay, so you need to just start thinking about those schemes that are related to employment generation, right? Let us go to the second paragraph. So among these three schemes, okay, is a flagship placement linked skill training program, right? So which has a mission to ensure rural poor youth are skilled in market relevant trades and job relevant competencies. So we are referring to a particular program or a scheme which is basically placement linked skill training program. So this is the keyword in this particular passage, right? So it says over 4.83 lakh rural youths have had placements under this scheme till date. So this is one current information about this particular scheme that we have added to this particular paragraph, right? So usually in examination, this is going to be a question. Now based on this particular paragraph, you are required to solve the questions, okay, that follow. So the first question that I always tell you most of the times is going to be the identification of the scheme that is being talked about in the passage. Now to identify, you need to first make sure that you have understood the crux of the passage, that it is one of the employment generation programs. The second important point being it is a flagship placement linked skill training program, right? So the first question out here friends, identify the scheme talked about in the passage, come up with your answers guys. Let us see. So yes, Dhruv says it is B, that is Deen Dayal Upadhyay Grameen Kaushalya Yojana. Swapnil also agrees with it, it is B. And Mayur says it is A, that is Aspire program. And Badri says C, that is Deen Dayal Antyodaya Yojana, National Urban Livelihoods Mission. Okay guys, now you need to tell me, okay, let us see what is the answer for it, right? So the answer for this particular question is B, that is Deen Dayal Upadhyay Grameen Kaushalya Yojana. Okay, so this is the particular answer for the question that we have been discussing, right? So you can see that all these schemes are close enough, so there is a possibility that you might get confused with the options. Okay, so you need to be very clear with the objective of each of these schemes. And one other important thing friends out here, that usually you will not get the full forms, okay, only the abbreviations will be used, so you need to be very well aware about the full forms of the schemes as well, right? So now let us move on to the next important question. Okay, before that, let us see some important points regarding it. So this is a program that bridges the gap, okay, between the formal education, okay, and the skills that is required for one to get placed, okay. So basically it concentrates on the rural poor, okay, and they make sure that those people are given appropriate placement training, okay, and a good job at the end, okay. So this is the basic motive of this particular Deen Dayal Upadhyaya Grameen Kaushalya Yojana. You can see the tagline also, it says empowering India and powering the world, okay. Now moving on to the next question. Okay, so now comes the question regarding the implementing ministry. Okay, so the scheme which is talked about in the passage comes under which of the following ministries, right? So now we have understood that obviously the scheme that is being talked about is the Deen Dayal Upadhyaya Grameen Kaushalya Yojana. Now you need to tell me under which of the following ministries does the scheme work. Okay, so guys, yes, tell me under which scheme it is, under which ministry is this particular scheme. So guys, come out with the answers. Let us just discuss and then we will see what is the answer for it. So Dhruv says it is Rural Development Ministry. Any of you else, like any other answers apart from Rural Development Ministry? So guys, think it is close. There can be a confusion between, I guess, the skill development one and even the rural development. So Jagannath Biswas says Ministry of Labour and Employment, okay. And Uday Kumar says E, since it is linked to the placement linked skill training program. So there is a possibility that most of you might think it is E. So just come up with the answer. Swapnil says D, Ministry of Rural Development. Tanuja says C, Human Resource and Development, okay. And Swapnil again emphasizing it D. Okay, so let's see what is the answer. Any of you, just try attempting it. It's just a discussion that is going on. Okay, fine. So yes, most of you coming up with Ministry of Rural Development. Let's see what the answer is. Gagan is saying E. So yes, as I told you, there is a confusion between rural development and skill development on entrepreneurship. So that the confusion is obvious out here. Okay, so the answer for this particular question, friends, is going to be D. It is Ministry of Rural Development. Now, why I have put this particular question is, as you can see the second paragraph, it clearly says that this is a scheme which is a placement linked skill training program. Okay, so this is a keyword here. Okay, so most of the time what happens is we read this and we immediately come to a conclusion that it would fall under the Ministry of Skill Development and entrepreneurship. So this is a very obvious mistake that most of us would make, right? So that is why make sure that you do not make this mistake in the examination. It comes under the Ministry of Rural Development, right? Yes, Dhruv is saying that PM Kaushal Vikas Yojana comes under skill development. Yes, try linking like that. Okay, so yes, okay, fine. Now there are some other important information as well. So obviously we have seen it comes under Ministry of Rural Development, and what does it do? It makes sure that training is given to rural youth so that they can get placed. Okay, the skill training programs are being arranged for them. Okay, now this particular scheme involves the state governments. Okay, we will see the three-tier implementation model of the scheme in the coming section. Okay, so do not worry. Okay, and this particular scheme lecture can also be downloaded in the form of PDF. Okay, so there you can see these important points. I'll be discussing only the ones which I think you need to be conveyed. Okay, so here you can see that this particular scheme has a three-tier model for implementation. You can see on your screens at the national level. Okay, that national unit is involved in policy making. It provides tech support and it acts as a facilitation agency, right? And at the state level, there are Deen Dayal Upadhyaya Grameen Kaushalya Yojana state missions. Okay, they are responsible for providing implementation support. Okay, friends. Then there is the last part, which is a very important component. Okay, which is the project implementing agencies, PIAs. Okay, so these PIAs are responsible for implementing the program by conducting skill and placement projects. Okay, so these PIAs can be trust. Okay, they can be certain registered societies. They can be state cooperative societies. They can be big business houses. Right. So they need to fulfill certain important criteria, and then they are allowed to provide skill development training. Right. Fine, friends. So we are here with the next important question out here. So it says that the scheme aims to target the rural youth in which of the following age groups? Okay. So basically, this is a placement link training program, but it targets people in specific age bracket. Okay. So you need to tell me which is that age bracket out here. Okay. So you need to let us see if you guys can attempt this question. The options are quite close. Okay, and that is going to be the case even in the examination. So you need to attempt this particular question. So either it is 15 to 20 years, or 15 to 25, 15 to 35, 15 to 40, or 20 to 40. So Vibhav says it is C, 15 to 35. Okay, and Swapnil says C, Tanuja says C, Dhruv Chopra says D. Okay, different answer, 15 to 40. Vadnal Mangai says C, and again 15 to 35. Okay, thank you for writing the option. I can spot it off. So Swapnil again 15 to 35. Premnath says C. Okay, so most of you are going for 15 to 35. Sumit comes up with D. Okay, Kriti C, Mayur again. Okay, Gopal C. So most of you are C, but some confusions there as well. 15 to 25 also is being chosen. So yes, guys. So Kriti is very sure. She says sure it is 15 to 35. Let us see if she is right. So yes, friends, the answer is right. Most of you have judged this answer properly, and yes, the answer is correct. 15 to 35 years basically, right? So this scheme targets the rural youth, which is falling under the age bracket of 15 to 35 years, right? So yes, here you can see important points regarding eligibility. Okay, so basically it is targeting rural youth, okay, which lie under the age group of 15 to 35 years. And there's also a relaxation in age when it comes to SC/ST women and tribal groups, particularly vulnerable tribal groups, then persons with disabilities. For them, the bracket is up to 45 years, right? So friends, are you experiencing any buffering? Am I not audible? It is not clear. Please let me know in the comment section below. Okay, friends, so this is the eligibility, and you need to memorize it. See in the question whether they are asking you for the general criteria or they are asking you specifically for these sections like SC/ST women, right? Okay, so now it is audible. I guess I can resume it. Okay, fine. So the next question, the fourth one, okay, it says, which of the following placement linked skill training program is being implemented in the state of Jammu and Kashmir for the unemployed youth of the state? Okay, so again, this particular question is linked to same thing, placement linked skill training program. Okay, but it is specifically referring to Jammu and Kashmir state. Okay, so you need to tell me what is the name of this particular program, right? So guys, just try attempting this particular question. You need to tell me the answer for it. So just see, there are closer options. You need to guess which option is correct. So Chitransh says it's B, Himayat. Okay, Dhruv also says Himayat. Okay, Uday says he doesn't know. Okay, Tanuja A, Roshni. Okay, Swapnil with B. Okay, so there are a lot of schemes actually. Swapnil again says Himayat. Okay, yes, I've got it. Okay, Badri again goes for Himayat. So most of you saying Himayat. Okay, Shubham comes up with Umeed, I guess. Okay, Kriti Sinha says she has no idea. Fair enough. Okay, so Mayur again A. Sumit Kumar says E. Okay, Umeed. Prasanna Nayak B. Most of you are going with B, I guess. Okay, so Swapnil again says B. So Satyam, okay, B. So most of you are going with the B option. So, okay, fine. Okay, Himayat means support. Okay, one extra information we have got. Selva B, Satya again B. Any of you guys wanting to attempt it? So I guess, yes, I think all of you should participate. Only then, you know, these things are going to retain in your minds basically. Okay, yeah, Pratham is an NGO. Dhruv caught the option. So I was trying to come up with some closer options. So yes, it is an NGO. Okay, so let me ask you one question. Maybe Dhruv, if you can try it out. So Pratham releases a particular report. So tell me which report it is. It is related to the education sector now. Just to, you know, invoke certain questions in your minds. So let me know. You can write it in the comment section below as well. Okay, so Roshni in tribal areas, Dhruv says. Okay, fine. Okay, so let us just see what is the answer for this particular question, right? So the answer is Himayat, right? Yes, most of you were correct in guessing the answer for this particular question. So this particular scheme is related to placement linked skill training programs specifically in the state of Jammu and Kashmir, right? So this is a very important program. So you need to know the names of it, okay? Okay, so let us see some of the important points regarding Himayat. So basically, as I told you, in the state of Jammu and Kashmir, and it is in place since 2011. Okay, and one important thing is it targets both urban and rural population irrespective of levels of poverty. So this is an important feature of this particular scheme. So usually training is provided for nearly 3 to 12 months. Okay, and those areas are picked up in which there's a good market demand. Okay, so those skills are given to the rural and urban youth, okay, of JNK, and it is made sure that they are placed, and even there is 1 year post placement tracking that is done. Okay, now apart from that, if you can see, there's yet another program which is again linked to skill training. Okay, it is called Roshni, as one of you rightly pointed out that it has a special focus on northeast region and 27 left wing extremist districts. Okay, so again you can see that there are variations and the names you need to keep in mind. Okay, now friends, let me just tell you that there is one other scheme which is called Nai Roshni. Okay, now because we are reading this term Roshni, I just got remembered of that. Now you need to tell me what is this Nai Roshni. I'm not going to tell you, so you need to think about what is that particular scheme. Okay, and yes, Dhruv, it is ASER. Okay, fine, good. So you start linking these things, friends, whenever, like, you know, he said immediately Pratham is an NGO, so you need to start linking, okay, which is the report that it releases. Okay, so these small things are actually going to help you in the examination. Okay, so it's very fine. Okay, so let me just move on. Okay, so next important question. So yes, is this session useful for AFO exam? So friends, actually in AFO exam, mostly you are asked schemes from the agriculture sector specifically. So directly it is not going to be useful. If agriculture schemes are discussed, then definitely it is going to be useful for AFO. Right? Okay. So the next question of ours, in which of the following years was this scheme launched? Okay. So we are talking about the launch year of this particular scheme. So yes, you guys need to start attempting. Give me the answers for this particular question. Let us see how many of you are attempting at least. So Vibhav says it is 2014. Dhruv says D. Is it 2015? Let us see. We'll find out. Uday Kumar, 2011. Selva, again 2011. Mixed responses for this particular question. Quite confusing. Confusing, I guess. Chitransh says it is B, 2014. Uday Kumar, 2014. Okay, Kriti says 2015. Closer options. So most of you are confused. Swapnil comes up with 2015. So Vibhav again, 25th September 2014. Are you googling it out then and there, I guess? Okay, fine. So Swapnil, okay, D. Jagannath says 2015. Prem Nath says 2011. Tanuja, B. Sumit Chaudhary, D. That is 2015. Okay, so most of you are confused between all the options, and that was the intention to give closer options. I guess there's one guy who has googled it out. Oh, okay, giving credit to him, he knows it. It's Vibhav Pandey saying 25th September 2014. Okay, so let us see what is the correct answer. Are you wanting to attempt more? Okay, people are coming up with answers. Satya says 2011 and Sumit Kumar says it is B, that is 2014. So let us see what is going to be the answer. Okay, Sumit Kumar, fine. So let us go with the answer for this particular question. So the answer is 2014. So yes, most of you confused with this particular question. So this is how it is going to be in the examination too. You will get very close options for to solve. Okay. So Badri says, will we be required to remember the year of launch as well? Yes, you do. You need to remember the year of launch. And if the scheme is new, you have to remember the place of launch also. Okay, because sometimes there are questions on in which place was this particular scheme launched, provided if it is new, not for the old schemes. Okay, so that is one important thing. Okay, so as one of our friends rightly pointed out, Vibhav said it is 25th of September 2014, exactly the same data, right? And okay, so it was launched on the occasion of 98th birth anniversary of Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyay, right? So yes, we can also see there's one other important point that you can see here, that this particular scheme actually has its origin in one of the earlier programs. Okay, it was called Ajivika Skills Program. Okay, so this is again important information. So you can say that yes, most of the features of Ajivika Skills have been incorporated into this particular program. So kindly make note of this as well, right? So fine. Then Badri Narayan, it is not difficult, it is easy actually. You can just, you know, as I told you, keep revising it. Okay, so now see, in this discussion we have spent nearly some 3 to 4 minutes discussing the launch year of this particular scheme. So do you think you're going to forget that it is 25th September 2014 after a lot of discussion, right? Many of your friends are coming up with the exact answer. So it's really good. Okay, so that is why I tell you, if you want to remember these things, participate in the discussion so that, you know, you'll remember these points in the examination. Okay, a very healthy way of remembering things. Okay, friends, so coming up with the last question for today. So it says, recently the implementing ministry of the scheme. Okay, we are not mentioning the answer directly because then you'll get a clue, right? So recently the implementing ministry of the scheme has signed an MOU with Maruti Suzuki Limited for training the rural youth under which of the following policy? Okay, so something is happening under this particular scheme. Okay, and as per this signing of MOU with Maruti Suzuki Limited, it is going to provide training for rural youth. Okay, but this particular training which it is going to provide is coming under a particular policy. Okay, so this is a policy which is again a part of this this particular scheme that we are discussing. So you need to tell me which policy is this. Now friends, this particular news that I'm referring to, the signing of MOU with Maruti Suzuki, was a news lately. In fact, I guess on December 18th this notification was out. So now this is something related to current affairs. You might get a question on this. Now let me know the answers from your end. A tricky questions, I guess. Uday Kumar says D, Selva says C, Jagannath says D, okay, Sahitya says C, Dhruv says no clue, Chitransh says it is D, and Prasanna says D. Okay guys, Kriti says no idea. So I was finally successful in coming up with options where you're not able to spot the correct answer. So okay, given credit to me at least in this case. So Sumit Chaudhary says don't know. Come on guys, just guess. Let's see. Pavan Kumar says D. Okay, any of you want to make an attempt? So guys, come up with this, come up with answers as I tell you, right? It is really good to have discussion out here. So okay, I think I'm waiting for Vibhav's response. Yeah, Vibhav says nope. Okay, he doesn't know this one. Okay, so guys, any of you want to come out with answers? Gopal says A. Okay, let's see, any of you? Yes, I'm just waiting. I'll wait for a minute. I need answers from you guys for this particular question. It's very interesting actually. So let's see. Okay, so any more answers, friends? Okay, Swapnil has come finally. Okay, so A. Sumit Kumar is saying he thinks it is C. Okay, so Sumit, in exam if you think like this, then I would recommend you need to, you know, skip this question. Okay, so wherever you get this thing in mind that I think this is going to be the answer, so a clue for you, that leave this question in exam. Okay, so it is good that you have mentioned it here. So guys, these are small tips that you need to always remember. Okay, do not bluntly go and, you know, mark anything that you feel. So it is very important for you to be sure. So Ashok Jangra says it is B, leading employees policy. Let's see, come up with more answers, friends. Let's see if you guys can spot it on. Himanshu Pandey says D, it's industrial internships policy. Okay, that name is actually sounding relevant, right? D option. Na? So that is why most of us are confused. Uday Kumar comes with champion employees policy. Okay, okay, so let's see. I think it's time we'll just see the answer for this particular question. Okay, so the answer for this particular question is champion employees policy, right? So friends, I think Gopal was the one who came up with this answer for the first time, the correct one, I guess. Well done. And rest of you as well, nice that you have attempted this question. Now see, this kind of question, if you get in the examination, only few of you should answer, like who know the answer very properly, because all these options are very confusing. You feel like it is industrial internship because that is what this program is intended to do, right? Then some of you might feel it is sunshine employers, okay, leading employers, but the answer actually is champion employers policy, right? Let us see some of the other features of it. Okay, now see, under this particular program, the employers can engage in three ways. Okay, first way is champion employers. Okay, second is captive employers. Third is industry internships. Okay, I will not go into the details of each. Okay, but let me tell you, see, under champion employers, these are those employers who can train and place 5,000 or more rural poor youth in 2 years. Okay, so if you can give us the guarantee to train and place 5,000 or more rural poor youth, then you would be regarded as champion employers. Okay, so in this case, what is going to happen is an MOU will be signed with these employers. So in the example, in the question that we were discussing, we saw that it is the MOU is signed with Maruti Suzuki Limited. Okay, so Maruti Suzuki will actually make sure that it trains and places 5,000 or more rural poor youth. Okay, so annually they need to place 2,500 rural youths minimum. Okay, so those employers are called champion employers, right? And now one more thing you need to keep in mind, that these criteria might be asked, okay, but this champion employees was in news lately, so that is why I framed a question on this particular phrase. Okay, okay friends, now see, have a look at this pie chart. I don't be bothered about the data because it is that of financial year 2015-16. Okay, and don't worry, you're not going to get questions from this particular area. Okay, I'm just showing you to give you an idea regarding what see the vast amount of areas that they have covered. They cover areas like beauty, culture and hairdressing, electronics, healthcare, even travel and tourism, construction, garment making. All these are skill based training. Okay, you can see the number of areas that are covered, so it is huge actually. See, banking and accounting also, security, apparels, hospitality. Okay, so this is just to give you an idea, okay, regarding the various sectors covered. Okay, so you don't have to remember anything out of this pie chart. Okay, just to be very clear. Okay, now this is the latest data. Okay, so this is taken from the website of the ministry, official website, okay, of Deen Dayal Upadhyay Grameen Kaushalya Yojana, right? So now you can see here that this is as on 30th of November 2018. We have various tabs, radio buttons, whichever you select, the corresponding data would be displayed. Okay, so here you can see that as on 30th November 2018, there is a target which is given, how many have been trained, how many have been placed. Okay, so you do not need to memorize all these numbers, but yes, when the examination is nearing, just make sure at least you have an idea regarding at least these trained people, right? So for now, just leave it. Okay, but when the exam is nearing, you can just have a look at this data by going to the official website. Okay, this is something which can which you can do, right? And one more important point which I forgot to add, basically captive employers are those who make sure that they employ these people within their own companies. Okay, so if they have requirements and if they have the vacancies of for people, then they would make sure that they take in these people whom they are training. Okay, and these champion employers also, if you see, you know, they also, their name is it's a kind of a brand building also. Okay, wherein you are training more than 5,000 people, and you also get some of your work done. You outsource them as well. You use it for your work also. So it is, you know, a give and take process that exists between the employers as well as the people who are getting the job. Fine. So now you can see here that this is a checklist which I always tell you that you need to make sure that you have done. And here we have seen the date or year place of its launch. In fact, we have seen the exact date also. Is it a new scheme or a rebranding of an existing scheme? We saw that there was a program which was called Ajivika Skills. Okay, so you can say kind of a rebranding. Okay, and ministry, obviously the Ministry of Rural Development. Okay, then the sub scheme, we have just seen that there is schemes which have specific focus region wise. Okay, for example, we saw Himayat for the state of Jammu and Kashmir. Okay, we saw then there's Roshni, okay, for left wing extremist areas. Then so these are important components of it. So beneficiaries, target population, it is rural youth, and we saw the eligibility, that is 15 to 35 years, and for other category it was 15 to 45. Yes, I guess I just need to see it again. Okay, and okay, these are the things we saw, the mechanism, three-tier implementation model, right? And then if you see the latest budget outlay. Okay, so yes, we are still to add this particular component. Budget is not out, right? So we don't know the allocation right now. Okay, and any current affairs related to the scheme? Yes, we have just now seen that the MOU being signed with Maruti Suzuki, and there we caught this term which was called champions. Okay, champion employers, right, friends? So yes, we are done with today's discussion of this particular scheme, and I really hope that this particular session is going to help you out and build your interest towards this particular area, which is schemes, which most of us, you know, usually run away from or find it very tough. It is very simple. Just join in every week for discussion and we are done, right? So friends, anything else you would like to ask me, any important thing, we are always there to clear your doubts. So I'll just wait for 2 minutes or so and then I'll end the session, right? Okay, friends, so basically, welcome. You're welcome, guys. Gopal, Dhruv, Sumit, Swapnil, Satya, Pramod, Uday. So all of you, thank you for joining in, and I really want you guys to keep this spirit on, wherein every week we come here, we discuss these schemes, which are really going to help us a lot, right? And Swapnil says, how many schemes we need to prepare? Swapnil, there's a long list, don't worry, but we will make sure that we together finish the schemes, right? And also we will be providing you a document also, so don't worry, we will try covering most of the schemes, at least the important ones, okay? And now, okay, Vibhav says, thank you. Welcome, Vibhav. Dhruv, I'm also looking forward for the next session with you guys. It is really a pleasure being with you all. It is really interesting to discuss these questions. Okay, Dhruv, we will try. I'll not commit anything as such, but we'll just try if more than one is possible, right? Pavan says, okay, welcome, Pavan. Chitransh, again, welcome. And really glad that you guys come in and discuss the answers with me, because only then, this is the only solution to remember these important facts. Trust me. Otherwise, there are so many things to remember. It becomes really tough. Yeah, Vibhav, we will try making it more than once, okay? So I'll just try it from my end, not committing as of now. So, okay. Uday says, announce next scheme so that we can prepare. See, Uday, that is not going to happen, okay? It's going to be a surprise for you guys, and you need to, you know, be live with me and then come up with the answers. So that is fun, actually, okay? So imagine that you get a random scheme in the examination. You need to apply those understanding here also, okay? So that's why we'll keep it that way. Okay, Nikhil is asking that how many years of government scheme we have to study for RBI Grade B 2019. So, okay, Nikhil, basically, see, I would not say that there is a span of years, like, you know, whether 10 years or 20 years or 5 years. See, you need to cover the important schemes in each of the sectors, okay? So that is very important, okay? And apart from that, obviously the schemes in trend, the present schemes are always important, plus whichever are the important schemes in various sectors, okay? So I would not say any spam, okay? Span, sorry. Okay, so Nilesh says it is a first live session. Thank you. Welcome, Nilesh. Satya, again, I'm saying you the same thing, that it's not good to announce the next scheme in advance. Okay, all the fun is going to go. Okay, so we need to interact. We need to make sure and be spontaneous. Come out with your answers. Okay, so this is a guesswork. You need to apply a bit here. Okay, fine. Okay, so Sunil Dangi, she's going out of context. Okay, no problem. We'll just cater to her request as well. Okay, so anything else, guys? I think I'll be leaving in a minute. So anything else you want me to address? So I really hope that you are revising these things. Please do not forget this once the live session is over. You need to carry this information till the last day, and in fact till the examination hall as well, right? Okay, friends, so once again wishing you all, okay, regarding AFO government schemes, let me just plan it out. I'll just see. Let me see what can be done regarding it. Okay, otherwise we have uploaded the government schemes already. So don't worry about that. Right. Shrikar is asking whether making short notes on schemes is advisable. See, Shrikar, as far as schemes are concerned, whatever schemes I'm taking here as part of the session, you can just download this PDF, okay? And that is more than enough, because I'm covering most of the thing that is available as part of the scheme. Apart from that, whichever scheme I'm not able to cover, yes, there you can go and make certain short notes, okay? It will help you to keep, you can retain those short notes for longer term as well, okay? So that can be done, fine? So, okay, guys, so anything else? Utkarsh is asking when the sessions are live. So, Utkarsh, basically, we come on every Wednesday, right? So, today is Wednesday, right? Yes, it is Wednesday. So, we will be coming up every Wednesday at 6 p.m., right? So, if there is any change, we'll let you know as in advance. But this is going to be the schedule as of now, okay? Yes, Shrikar, you're welcome. More than welcome, okay? Anything else, guys? Taking a minute or so. Okay, friends, so closing here now, and for any queries, kindly visit our website www.edutab.co.in regarding courses, or you can drop us a mail, hello@edutab.co.in. Give us a call at 814-620-7241, and we'll meet the next week, right? And till then, friends, again wishing you all a very, very, very happy new year. May all your wishes come true. Bless you with a healthy life, right? Okay, friends, bye. Thank you so much.